So welcome everyone. Today we are going to summarize the chapter that we discussed on elasticity. So before we go into the detail, first of all we'll define it and add details in this sheet. So first of all we'll talk about what is elasticity. So elasticity is actually the measure which tells how one phenomenon affects other, and in terms of percentage. So the elasticity actually measures how first factor which is used in the study is used to how first factor is affecting the second factor. So it's called and it is measured in terms of percentage. So what are the other things? It tells how. So before start with it, so there are in elasticity there are always two things under consideration. First is the dependent factor, which is the base and for which we are actually working. So first is the dependent factor, and in economics or in today's session, that factor is either quantity demand or quantity supply. And the second factor is the independent factor, and we are covering price of the product, income of customer, and price of some other related product. So we are covering these things. So now based upon that, we are now going to define what is elasticity. So elasticity will tell us, it will tell us how, tell us to what extent the dependent factor will change if the independent factors are changing by 1%. So we assume that the independent factor is changing by 1%. So for that independent variable, dependent factor will change by how much, we need to measure using the elasticity. Previously we have discussed using demand and supply framework, that that helped us to find the direction of the effect of independent factors, but it did not mention the exact magnitude of effects. So previous topic was about the direction and the idea, and this topic is about, it's actually the part of the previous topic, but it is studied differently or separately, because that previous topic was based upon graphs. Now this topic is based upon numerical calculations. So using the calculations, we will be able to measure the exact answer. So there are four types of elasticity. Which we are covering today. First is price elasticity. Demand. Second is income elasticity of demand. third is cross price elasticity of demand, and fourth is price elasticity of supply. From their name you can easily understand which one will be the dependent and which one will be the independent factor. The name which is coming at the end is the dependent factor. That name which is coming at the start is the independent factor. For example, in price elasticity of demand, the price will be the independent factor and the quantity demand will be the dependent factor. So this will be the topics that we are coming to. So we are starting with the first one. So first is the price elasticity of demand. So let's define it first. So it tells us how much quantity demand will decrease or increase if there is 1% increase or decrease in the price of that particular product. So this value will tell us the response. So in other words, it will measure the responsiveness of the customer with respect to the price of the product. So we will be able to measure how also it measures how sensitive the buyer's demand calculation psychological formula for the changes in the price of the product. So we will be able to see that this answer will tell us how sensitive the customer is to the changes in the price. Means if he is observing change in the price, how much he will change the quantity demand. So this is the meaning of elasticity demand. So the formula that is being used is, this is a formula shown here. So generally formula can be derived from first thing. First is, the formula is percentage change in quantity demand divided by percentage change in price. So this is actually the formula that is you mentioned in the books. So percentage change in quantity demand divided by percentage change in the price. So now the percentage change can be calculated in two ways. So one is midpoint method, second is the ARC method. So we are using the midpoint method or an average method so that we can find the average answer. So this is commonly used in the books. So if I open up this formula, how can we can write? So elasticity of price, EPD is price elasticity demand, which will be equal to percentage change in commodity demand. How we can measure percentage change? So percentage change is actually change divided by average of QD. It will measure percentage change and multiply by 100. So divided by how we measure the percentage change in the price. So change in price divided by average of price. So multiply by 100 will be cancelled from both sides. And since there is a divide here, we change the divide into multiply by switching the other side. So the formula is, change is Q2 minus Q1. Q2 is the new demand, and the Q1 is the old demand, and the new is measured after the event. What is the event? The event is a change in the price. So elasticity is measured when there is some event. So let's assume, we can write it here. Assume, so the event is the change in the price of product X. So there is an event that has happened. So how we can calculate elasticity of demand? So the formula is, we measure the change in the demand, that is new demand minus old demand divided by the average demand multiplied by average price divided by change in the price. So this is a formula that is used to calculate the price elasticity of demand. And I've already labeled the values. So Q1, Q2, and P1, P2 means that they are Q1, Q2 means it is old demand, and Q2 is new demand, P1 is old price, and P2 is new price respectively. So I'm labeling it like this so that you can see on the same sheet. So these are, this is the formula that is used. Now we'll go towards its example. So the answer of this numerical will always come. So range, let's put the range on the right hand side and talk about range. So it's on the answer of this numerical, it will always be negative. Why? So we already know, because of law of demand. Okay, so whenever there is so law of demand we discussed in the previous slides. So in the previous slides we discussed the law of demand as, when there is an increase in price, there is an increase decrease in demand of the product. So there is always an inverse relation. So as there is inverse relation between price and quantity, so the answer is expected to be negative. So that's why in the number line I've shown the answer can be between 0 and minus infinity. So it's a negative number range. So you need to remember that when you are solving this numerical, the answer will always be negative. So if you are solving it and you end up finding answer in positive, then you need to be aware that it may be because of some calculation error, or you may have used the brackets mistakenly. You used the wrong brackets, so that end up in changing the sign of the answer. So we have this table which is showing the filled numerical for elasticity. So let's see the example. So here is the values of quantity demand, and it is 0, 10, 20, 30. It is changing, and there are four examples, and there is a price of that product PX, and it is 6, 4, 2, 0. So it means we have seen that price is changed three times, from 6 to 4, 1, 4 to 2, 2, and 2 to 0, 1. So let's add another column here at the start and write event number. Let's insert and left column. So we can write event. So got it, 1, 2, 3. So there are three events that are being discussed in this numerical. So how I have solved it, you can see using numerical, I have just split down the formula and filled each component. So first is change in quantity, that is Q2 minus Q1. So that is 10 minus 0 is 10. Then 10, 20 minus 10 is 10. 30 minus 20 is 10. Then I have calculated change in price, that is 4 minus 6 is minus 2. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. 0 minus 2 is minus 2. So I have already filled. Then I need to calculate average. So 10 plus 0 divided by 2 is 5. 20 plus 10 divided by 2 is 15. 30 plus 20 divided by 2 is 25. Similarly, 6 plus 4, 10 divided by 2 is 5. 6 plus 2, 8 divided by 2 is 6 plus 4 plus 2, 6 divided by 2 is 6. 2 plus 0 divided by 2 is 1. So I have got the each component. Then I filled it in this formula and got three values of elasticity of demand. So it is EPD. So price elasticity of demand. So I'm going to interpret these three examples one by one, and then we'll see what are the meanings. So is event 1. So EPD is equal to minus 5. What does it mean? So it means that if there is 1% increase in the price of product X, then we will see that there is a decrease, there is a 5% decrease in the demand of product X. So it means that if the seller has increased price by 1%, the demander will decrease it by 5%. Okay, so event 2, EBD. So that is -1. So that if there is 1% increase in the price of product X, then we will see that there is a 1% decrease in the demand of product X. So you will see increase in price, and in response, the customer will decrease in the demand, and the response is equal and opposite. In the first case, the response was opposite but bigger. So event 3, EPD is -0.2. So if there is 1% increase in the price of product X, then we will see that there is a 0.2% decrease in the demand of product X. So it means that there are three examples. First example is saying that the response is in the region. Let's annotate here. So event one says that the answer is in this region. The answer is event one is here. So answer is in between -1 and 0. So -1 and -infinity. Event two is says that it is actually -1, and event three says that it is in between 0 and -1. Okay, so it means we have three different examples and three different types of answers. So let's fill it up. So I will label it. So here the demand is elastic to price. Elastic to price means that it the price has changed a little bit, but demand has changed more than that. So it means that the response of demander is more than the change in the price of the product in opposite side. So it means demander is able to respond more than what the price has changed. So we call it elastic price. So the demand is elastic. So he is able to respond it more than what has happened. Second is, let's here the demand is unit elastic, means because answer is one. So that means that the response of the demander is equal and opposite to the price. So in this case, demander is providing an opposite but equal response to the change in price. So exact answer. Okay, so we call it unit elastic. Third is, here the demand is inelastic. What is it, does it mean by inelastic? That the response of the demander is less than the price in opposite direction. So when there is an increase in price, there is a decrease in demand, but the decrease in demand is smaller in amount with respect to the price. So it means that there are three types of demand that we have covered. In three types of elasticity we have covered. First is the elastic demand. Second is union elastic demand. Third is inelastic demand. Okay, so why these answer does change? So let's go towards let's save it first and let's go towards the slides and see what are the reasons that explain the change in the price, change in the elasticity of the customer. So we are going to discuss what is the reason behind the change in the values of elasticity or change in the type of elasticity of demand. So we are going to study what makes it change. So why do you see that there are in you have three different types of elasticity? Let's go back to the slide and let me bring it up screen. So it's this one. Yes, so share screen. So you can see this in this slide we are going to discuss the factors affecting price elasticity of demand. So we are talking so first of all I will give you a few hint that what is actually the price elasticity of demand. So let's draw it here. So we have y-axis and we have an x-axis, and on x-axis we have quantity demand, and on y-axis we have price. So we are going to draw the demand curve. So we already know the demand curve will be negatively sloped. So the demand curve has a negative, but the angle that demand curve is making, there can be of three types. We will cover it later on. So, but let me change the color. It can be little bit flat, means it is not decreasing very fast. It can be normal case, or it can be a third type of, it can be decreasing very fast, like steep. So when the curve is steep, we call it, when the curve is steep, we call it elastic. When the curve is flat, we call it inelastic. So when the curve is flat, is actually elastic, because when curve is steep, then we call it inelastic. Okay, so let we'll cover it these diagrams later on so that it can be cleared. So it means we are now discussing three types of customers. First is the customer who has the elastic demand, and there is a unit elastic case which is in between both. So there are three types of customers. One is the elastic demand customer, another is inelastic demand customer, then there is unit elastic demand customer. So unit elastic demand customer is always in between both. So we don't have to measure who is the unit elastic person. We only have to look that who is elastic and who is inelastic. So I'm going to cover four examples. Hopefully you will be able to understand the reasons why there are two types of customers, the red one and the green one. So red one is a person who is elastic, means if there is an increase in price, he decreases demand more than the price. And the inelastic person is a person who decreases demand less than the price. Let's write it briefly here. So he is decreasing demand more than price. Okay, so means that if the price is increasing by 1%, so the demand is decreasing by more than 1%. And then there is another person who is here. I will make it in the bottom. So decreasing demand less than price. So he is a person who is not able to reduce the demand more than the price. So it means if there is an increase in price by 1%, the decrease in demand is less than 1%. So it means, so now we are going to see the first example. The first example is if we are comparing two products. So let's name these customers too, so that we can clear. So this is a customer. Let's see. So this is customer A. His name is A, and there's a customer that he is B. So we have two customers, customer A and B. Now we are comparing that one customer is buying an SST product. What is meant by necessity product? There is that he is buying maybe food item, he is buying medicine, sir. He is buying fruits, vegetables, what? So necessity goods are those goods which are water, medicine, food, shelter, clothing. So these are necessity. And luxury goods are the goods without which we can survive. So these can be designer shoes, big house, second car. Okay, and so these are luxury. So suppose the customer B is buying, so let me write it here, this is space. So B is buying necessity and A is buying luxury. So what will happen? That since and the examples are medicine. So B is buying a medicine. He went to a shop and he's going to buy a medicine. And the customer A went to a shop. He's going to buy designer shoes. So what will happen? Both of them experienced increase in price of medicine and shoes. So both of them are experiencing that there is an increase in price. So logically, we need to think who out of these two people, who is able to decrease in price, who is able to decrease in the quantity that they are willing to buy. So definitely the customer who is going to buy medicine, he is going to buy medicine because either he is ill or his relative or his family member is ill. So definitely he needs to buy the quantity in the same amount because doctors has ordered him. So if there is an increase in price, that customer who is buying medicine, the customer B, will not reduce the demand because he needs that product urgently so that he can give it to the patient. So in this case, the customer B is not buying the product because it is cheap. He is buying the product because he needs it. So necessity is superior than the price of the product. So it means whenever there is an increase in price, he will not reduce the demand because necessity is there to enforce him to buy the product. Secondly, for the designer shoe, since there are many brands available in the market, all of them are substitutes to each other. If the customer A sees that the brand that he is going to buy has become expensive, so what he will do? He will not buy the product and he will go to the other brand so that he can buy it from there. So it means customer A can reduce the demand more than the price because he is not buying the product because it is necessity. Is he buying the product because he thinks that the product is cheap? So that's why he's going to buy. So the response of the B will be lower than the response of A for how much? Let's see, 1% increase in the price of demand. So let's assume that both of the products the demand has increased by 1%. Price has increased by 1%. So what will happen? That the customer who is buying medicine will reduce the demand less than 1% because he needs the good. Maybe he will not reduce the demand if it is very highly necessity. So answer may be zero. And the person who is buying shoes may be reducing the demand more than 1% because he may shift to the other product and stop buying this brand because he thinks it is expensive. Now, this way you can differentiate between the elasticity of demand. So these two products are explaining that if the product is necessity or not a necessity, it will change the way customer responds to change in the price of the product. Now we go towards the second example. Here I will write with some different color so that you can differentiate it. So here the product is of two types. One is a mobile network, means you are buying mobile SIM, mobile connection, and second is a course pack that the teacher has asked you to buy it from the bookshop. So suppose the customer B is buying the course pack and A is buying the mobile SIM. So now what is the difference between these two goods? So we need to see. So the mobile networks, there are already too many substitutes available. There are 4 mobile networks available in Pakistan. So it's up to you which one you buy, and it depends upon the price, which one is cheaper. And for the case of course pack, there is no substitute. So when you go to the photocopier, there is only one type of course pack available, and you have to buy it no matter what it costs, because it is the requirement of the course to get that book, get that course pack to study. So it means what will happen? Let's write it here. So suppose there's an 1% increase in price of SIMs and course packs. Both of them are 1% expensive. We don't know what is the reason, but we assume that both of them are 1% expensive. So what will happen? The customer A who is buying SIM will shift to some other product. Maybe he will leave the Jazz and move to Ufone or Telenor or Varit or some other network, because the network that he was buying earlier is expensive. Now he needs to buy the cheaper one. So he will respond more than the price. So he will be in the red line. So his decrease in demand will be more than the increase in the price. Why? Because he has a liberty, he has the ability, he has the freedom to change, to not to buy the thing which is become expensive. So since he has the ability and the freedom, so what we will see that if there is an increase in 1% of the price, the customer will decrease the demand more than 1%, so that he can shift to some other product which is relatively cheaper. Now, for the case of course pack, what will happen? So here, since there is only one type, teacher has only ordered to buy that particular course book. So there is no other substitute. So what will happen? The customer will not be able to reduce the demand or shift to some other product because there is no other product available. There is no other product available where he can go. So what will happen? He will be in the green line. So there is 1% increase in the price of course pack, and the customer is not reducing the demand because there are no substitutes available for this product. Now let's select some other color, blue. So in the third case, let's write it down. So there are the two customers are buying different things. So customer A or B is buying the birthday card and
is paying for his uni fee. So both of them buying a different thing. One is buying a birthday card, another is paying for the university. So let's assume the event has happened, that there is 1% increase in price of birthday card. Let's write it in short. So card and tuition fee. So the event has happened. So what will happen? So let's see it in this way. So what is the proportion of the cost of the product? So the birthday card, it will be less than 1% of the income of the customer. So the cost of birthday card is smaller than 1% of the income that the customer is earning. And the tuition fee, it will be costing more than maybe 50% of the customer's income, maybe his parents' income. So what will happen, since you are paying tuition fee quarterly, so that will be a big amount. So it means that since the birthday card has a very small proportion in the cost of the customer, so if the birthday card become expensive, customer will not bother that much. You will say, what will happen if it is less than 1%? It will be little bit higher, but it will be still less than 1%. So suppose the birthday card is 100 rupees and it has increased 1%, means it is now 101 rupee. So what it will create a change? It will not create change anything, because a customer's income is way more than 100 rupees. But for example, the tuition fee is 1 lakh rupees. So what will happen if there is a 1% increase? It will be 1,10,000. So there's a 10,000 rupee increase in the customer's 10,000 rupee increase in the cost of the tuition. So, but customer B will not respond. He will be inelastic. Why? Because it doesn't matter. There is a very small proportion increase. But the customer A will retaliate. He will request the university to not to increase the price at least, or if he is taking an admission, he will not take an admission. He will switch to some other university or some other college. So what will happen, that the customer A will respond to the demand, to the situation, but the customer B will not respond to the situation. Okay, so this way the there will be a difference in the response. So let's see the next case. So now suppose the next example is, let's see, let's select some other color so that we can differentiate it. Let's start with orange. So okay. So now assuming that there are two goods. So customer B is buying a product at lump sum price, means he is paying the price altogether. There is no installments. And A is buying the product in installments. Okay, so both of them are buying different product, and they have different nature. So let's write the exact case. So what will happen? So there is 1% increase in this price, in the price. So both are buying same thing. B is buying at lump sum price. He's paying all the price altogether at so in cash or via credit card or via debit card, but not installments. Customer A is buying via installments. So what will happen? Suppose the price of the product has increased. So the customer B, I have written it opposite. So it's customer A here, is here, and B is here. So whenever there's an increase in price, since the customer A is paying a lump sum, he will feel that it is expensive now, because he have to pay at that point. So he will respond more than the increase in price. His response will be more than the
increase in price in opposite direction. But the product B, the customer B, since if the price is increased by 10 rupees and he has taken 10 installments, so it means he will only feel that price has increased 1 rupee per installment. So he will not feel the increase in the price. So his response will be lower than the increase in price. So this way, customer A will be in the red and customer B will be in the green. So this way, there's a difference. Now we'll go towards the last case. Let's select some other color. And so the last case is the definition of the product. So let's write it down here. So customer B is buying tomatoes and A is buying vegetables. Okay, so let's complete it here and then write the case here. So what has happened? There is 1% increase in price of vegetables and tomatoes. So what will happen? So the customer B will not be able to retaliate because there is no alternative available for tomatoes. He has to buy tomatoes because it is necessity for him. So if the tomatoes are expensive, he has to buy the tomatoes. So he is inelastic. But the person who is buying vegetables, so there are too many substitutes for vegetables because he has not defined which product he is buying. He is buying vegetables. So all the vegetables are substitute to each other. So whenever there is an increase in price of a broad category, then what will happen? Then the customer will be able to respond because in broad categories there are many substitutes available. So the customer A is in the red line and the customer B is in the green line. So this way we can differentiate between the elasticity of demand. So now we are going to see what will happen in the market with respect to a seller if the seller has increased the price. So first example that we are covering is what will happen if the product is inelastic. So the seller is thinking that they should increase the price. So here what will happen if there is an increase in price and then the customer is inelastic in terms of demand. So what will happen? So there is a demand for medicine. This is steep. So steep means inelastic for the case of demand. And the original price was 1 rupee per unit and the customers was willing to buy 100 units. So this was the original case. But the seller thought and seller is getting a revenue of 100 rupees. That is 1 multiplied by 100. Price into quantity. So then the seller is thinking that they should increase the price to 3 rupees. But since the product is necessity, the customer will only reduce it to from 10 to 80. So it means the revenue is now how much? 3 multiplied by 80, that is 240. So what has happened? That the inelastic demand customer is not able to reduce the demand to a point where seller faces reduction in revenue. So there is no reduction in the revenue because the buyer has not reduced the demand to that extent. So that there is no reduction in demand. So this way there is increase. So it means in this case, seller will enjoy profits when he increases the price. So seller likes to sell the product in the case where the product is inelastic. Now we go to the next point. Let's see. Okay. So now what will happen if the product is elastic? What will happen? So what will happen? So example is demand for designer shoes and the original price was 1 rupee and they were buying 100 units. So the revenue that the firm was earning was 100 rupees. So
So now what happened? Seller has increased the price by 1 rupee. So but the customer has reduced the demand to 45. So what is the revenue now? It is 90. So revenue has reduced. So let's write it here. So what has happened that the elastic demand customer has been able to reduce demand to a point where seller is experiencing loss in revenue. Okay, so because the response was bigger than the price in opposite direction, so it means in such case you will never see seller to reduce the price. So what does it mean that in this type of market you will always see the seller is providing product discounts? There are always discounts in this market. So when, so for example, designer clothes, designer shoes, so you will always see they are launching new sales. So why they are not increasing the price? They are not increasing the price because they know that increase in price will reduce the demand more than the increase in price. So there will be a loss. So rather than they increase the price, they reduce the price. On other side, if the product is inelastic, they reduce the price rather than they increase the price rather than decreasing it, so that they can earn higher profit. Let's see if let's go to the, so this is the last, so summarizing the strategy. So here you can see in an inelastic market, the since the customer is not able to reduce the demand, so seller will like to sell it expensive. That's why you notice that the things that are inelastic are becoming expensive, because the seller knows that a customer is forced to buy this good, so they will always exploit that opportunity. On other side, if the product is inelastic, the seller cannot exploit because they know that buyer will shift to other substitute. So what will happen? They will not. So let's see what is shown here. So good for the firm to increase the price, and firm should introduce more sale offers. So this is the strategy for the firm. So this way we discuss the topic of elasticity of demand.